Hello friends, welcome to the new series of the Teaching Aptitude MCQs for the UGC NET and the SET examination. In this lecture, I'll be covering the Teaching Aptitude MCQs from the topic Research Aptitude. So if you are watching my channel for the first time, I request you to subscribe to our channel. And the rules for this MCQ series are simple. Pause the video when question appears on your screen and try to answer. And anyways, I'll be answering the question there itself. The first question is, what is the purpose of research aptitude section in the paper 1 for the candidates of the UGC NET and SET examination? So friends, the option B here is increase the difficulty level of the test. It is it can be eliminated. If they wanted to increase the difficulty level, they would have included the more difficult subjects like hard level math or top level advanced level math. But that cannot be the option. To develop the scientific approach in the aspiring candidates, this also cannot be the option, because it is not the duty of the screening agency to develop the scientific approach. All they do is they want to screen whatever candidates that are given to them. They want to screen them for the scientific approach, and they want to identify the scientific approach in the candidate. So the correct answer for this question is the to identify and screen the candidate with scientific approach. So friends, this is the correct answer. This is the objective of the research aptitude section in the UGC NET paper 1. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, field study in the research is related to. So friends, when field study is something which is related to the real life situations, so generally researcher go into the whatever research he is doing into the real life situations, where he can, if his research is about economics, I'm giving the general examination, he goes in the market and study it for say some specific period. Now that is the field study. You go in the, it is not something which is done in the laboratory or not in the some experimental condition. So it is the real life situation. So field study, remember this, field study is about the real life situations. Now moving on to the next question. What is the synopsis of a research project? Now friends, when I say synopsis, all you what should come into your mind is the abstract. So synopsis is the abstract of what is done during the project or what is done in the project. So it is the abstract. So remember this, it is not the blueprint. Blueprint of research is the research methodology. The plan of research is the research methodology, and it is the summary. When I say abstract, so it is the summary. What is the abstract? Abstract is summary of the finding of the research. So the correct answer is the summary of the finding of the research. Whenever a synopsis someone asks, or anything related to synopsis, abstract, so these are the similar word in some like these are the similar terms. So it is the summary related, summary, abstract, synopsis. So remember these things. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following proposition is not true about the research? So friend, this is interesting question which I have included. It improves the quality of teaching. So friends, it is proved that there is no relation between the researcher being a good researcher and he can be a good teacher. He may be a bad researcher, but he can be a good teacher. So there is no relation. Option A is ruled out. Now if it leads to finding of solutions. So friends, thing is, like when you do research, you will understand that it's not about finding the solutions. Not every time, almost 99% you end up nowhere in the research. So it is not true here. Only 1 or 2% people will find some solution, but 98% about, like there is nothing. You cannot like do a very path breaking research or something. Now that also is ruled out. Now the option D, it contributes to the social progress of the country. Now see, research as such is helpful. The data generated by research is helpful in the in implementing the schemes, but it is not directly contributing to the social progress of the country. Now the correct answer for this, if you are a researcher, you will understand, it is joyful. It is not a true statement. Research is very painstaking. You have to really give your lot of time, and you have to really work very hard, which is not really joyful. Sometimes you feel like you should leave the research. So and more often you don't enjoy it when it like it becomes painstaking, but there is a joy of finding that comes after you get results, but it is not joyful when you start from the beginning. So the not true about research is it is a joyful. So it is not joyful, it is a painstaking, but there is some like when you have inspiration you go on doing research. So the not true about research is it is joyful. Moving on to the next question, which of the following are the qualities of good researcher? So friends, it is this is a very important question. First is he picks up vast area and tries to understand the minute details. So this is not you when you are doing research, you have to find a very specific area. So you remember whenever a researcher works, he should like the general guideline is you should pick the specific problem and not the vast problem. See, when you pick a vast problem, there are a lot of things which can be done, but for a particular researcher to cover all those things, it is almost equal to impossible. So here we can option A and C can be limited as she picks up vast area, that is not possible. Now picks up the specific area and tries to understand the basic detail. So this is not correct here. So she cannot pick the specific area and understand the basic detail, then there will be no research. Now she picks up the specific area and tries to understand the every minute detail of that area. So that is a quality of a good researcher. So friends, I hope this is clear to you. If there is some doubt, you can ask in comment section. Now moving on to the next question, the example of scientific knowledge is, so option is authority of prophet or a great man. So this cannot be a scientific knowledge. It is say it cannot be trusted because there is no experimentation. Social tradition and customs, these are also not based on the scientific this thing. Now religious scriptures are also not scientific, because see, what is the scientific knowledge? What we call scientific knowledge, which can be reproduced and which is reliable. So what is that thing? The laboratory and field experiment which can be reproduced. If I say something, there should be some proof. So someone like say if I say something, a person has to for proving me wrong, he has to do some experiment, and if he proves me wrong, then it can be like okay, this is not a scientific knowledge, it is some fake thing. But when I am saying something which is reproduced and reproduced by many, then it is a scientific knowledge. So that can be done only in laboratory and field experiment. All other options are not true here. So the correct answer is the laboratory and field experiments. Moving on to the next question, a researcher selects only 10 members as a sample from the total population of 5000 and consider it good because. So this is the question from the sampling. So friends, remember when sample size is low, all you need, it should be a homogeneous. When like what is mean by homogeneous? When I am from a school, if I have to take a sample of the students, so what will I do when I take some from 5th grade, some from 10th grade, so there will be a lot of age difference. So that will not be the correct homogeneous size. From school of say 1 lakh students, if I take only from the 5th class which has 5000 students, so their age, their all the thinking and everything will be same. So if I take from the 5th class 10 people, that is the homogeneous sample for me. So the for that, for a researcher, now this answer to this will be the population should be homogeneous. So remember this, when you are taking a small sample, it should be homogeneous. So now moving on to the next question, a bibliography given in a research report. So option A is helps those interested in further research and studying the problem from another angle and makes the report authentic. Option C is both A and C, and D is none of the above. So the bibliography, friends, what is it? Like I'm giving a simple this thing, when someone writes an article, or say for that matter a paragraph, a simple paragraph, if I write something that can be just a hypothetical thing that just came out of me and I wrote, and there is no reference given to it. So what is bibliography? It is a references given to the paragraph I wrote. If someone want to, someone is interested and do further research, there is nothing, there is no bibliography. So that cannot be considered as authentic. So if you bibliograph it, when you reference it, you give references, so it can be, it will help those who are interested to further research, to cross check those references which I have given. And one more thing is, when there is a reference, you are actually referring them which is already reported, so it makes your report authentic. So these are the things. So the correct answer here is both A and B, that is C, option C. Now moving on to the next question. Friends, so there is no next question. I hope you have liked it. If you have liked it, please share and subscribe to Global Online University. Thank you.